ready to match the star. Bobby Vann, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Adrienne Barbeau, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
You really want to do this, eh? You want to go ahead with this?
Yes, I love my job.
I'm happy in my work. I'm a square peg in a square hole.
Is that what this is?
That's what they said. Psychology.
What does that mean?
That means I'm a well-adjusted, happy kid.
You see Fanny's sweater?
I have an announcement that he's too humble. You know, Richard Dawson, you'll agree, is the sex symbol of daytime television. Isn't that right?
Just a darn minute.
Speaking of sex symbols,
yes.
I just wanted to say that he's getting ready to do a nude centerfold in Home and Gardens, and we're all looking forward to it.
That's true.
Did
it is really
Richard and the cactus.
With an apple. Right.
That's why he's growing the beard.
Now you get a chance to see that.
You see that sweater? My
God. It's W.C. Fields.
Oh, there is W.C. Fields.
Gene, did you ever see such bags under a guy's eyes? And you're like...
I think we should press on at this point.
Yes, I hope so.
Civilians here, Bob Marklin and Karen Robbins there. How are you?
Good.
Okay. All right. Bob's our current champ with $6,050. And when we were together last time, this game ended in a tie, 4-4. So we're going to wipe that slate clean and go to a tiebreaker and see who is the winner here right after we go to this message. Oh, I have a good time here. I don't know about the rest of you, but I love coming to work here every day. Now we're in a tiebreaker. One question for each of you. The one who has the most will be the winner. Go, Karen.
B.
B it is. You had that last time, didn't you? All right, here we go. Grandma Jones never uses a bottle opener. When she wants a beer, she pries off the bottle cap with her blanks.
Did you say blanks or...
Blanks.
Or blank.
B-L-A-N-K-S is what I said, with an S on it. When she wants a beer, she pries off the bottle cap with her blanks.
What are you looking at me for?
You're no grandma. Don't think about it too hard because you'll strain something and then we'll have to get a substitute for it.
You were on Tattletales today, did you know that?
Oh, Tattletales, following this show, Helen and I, my wife, what's her name, and I, and Gary and his wife, Janet, and who else was on that show?
Nobody.
Yeah, Orson, no.
Amanda Blake and her lovely husband,
Frank. Oh, Amanda Blake and her lovely husband, Frank Gilbert.
I said nobody.
We're on this.
I love her, I couldn't resist.
Yeah.
Hi, Fran.
All right, here we go. Karen Robbins. Grandma Jones never uses a bottle opener. When she wants a beer, she pries off the bottle cap with her blanks.
Blanks. Teats. Teeth.
With her teeth.
Teeth.
She said teeth. All right. She said teeth, which is the plural of tooth.
Tooth.
And we were looking for a plural answer, and she gave us one. Did you give us a plural answer?
No, I didn't say teeth.
What did you say?
Boobs.
With her boobs.
Of course.
I
hope
you're not a heavy drinker.
What are you saying?
Well, it was plural, right?
Right.
So you couldn't say teeth. You had to say toofies.
Toofies.
That's one for you.
Okay, Gary.
She was actually Gabby Hayes' mother.
Oh.
She gummed them off with her dentures.
With her dentures.
That's a match.
There's another one.
Well, that surprises me. I thought I was going to say,
pried it off with her hands. What did you say?
Well, I knew it was plural, but I had a feeling about Karen, and I
you
said
teeth. Going along pretty good there, Karen.
You got a grandma, right?
She's a grandma.
Gummed it off.
Gums.
That's what they all do.
Close, right? And you, Fanny?
Dentures.
Dentures, okay. Yeah. That's four for you. Now, Bob, we had a 4-4 tie last time. Now, you need 4 to tie, 5 to win. At the Roman Colosseum,
yes.
After the lion fought Gloria...
How badly did he fight?
Don't interrupt it, you can't. At the Roman Colosseum, after the lion fought Gloria, the lion smiled,
Because he was glad he blanked her. At the Roman Colosseum, after the lion fought Gloria, the lion smiled because he was glad he blanked her.
You want to dance?
Because would he was like glad to, he blanked her.
Would you like to rewrite the question?
No, it's a little... it's a perfectly terrific question.
I love that.
Let me just see if anyone is on the same wavelength. You got it. I mean, some people here have IQs of at least 12.
Watch it, Jane.
Come on now. Put them cards. Keep them cards and letters coming. All right. Gary, we're waiting for you drawing pictures on your card again.
None of your business.
Okay. Right. Now, Bob Marquand. At the Roman Colosseum, after the lion fought Gloria, the lion smiled because he was glad he blanked her.
Kissed?
In a moment, you'll find out where you went astray. As we call on our celebrities here.
That's right.
He really is just another pretty face, isn't he?
The lion smiled because he was glad he
ate her.
Glad he ate her. He was at the Roman Colosseum and the gladiator. He's a poor fellow.
You have to explain it. He deserves a kiss.
Okay, now, Brett, it's up to you.
Oh, no, he's crazy about it. He was glad he met her.
Glad he met her? You didn't understand it either, did you?
Go home with him.
All right.
I'm just another pretty face.
You got to match everybody else to stay in the game, Bob. Gary.
After all, he realized that the lady was not for eating the minute he pawed her.
He pawed her. So Karen Robbins wins the game. Now, there's no crying here, because if you cry, your mascara will run, so stop that now. Now, you cool it for a second there while we say goodbye to Bob Marquand, who is leaving here with $6,050. What are you going to do with all that money?
I'm
going to
spend it.
Spend it, attaboy, Bob Marquand. Nice to have you with us, Bob. Goodbye. Now, we'll get back here to Karen Robbins and the Big Money Super Match in a moment or so, but right now, we've got to do a little business, and this is it. All right, I'll get it for you later. Hello there, you remember me?
Yeah, I sure do.
What's my name?
Helen.
Come on, Helen. Helen.
We're not going on here. You're not going to get a chance at big money unless you tell me my name.
I can't think.
This girl doesn't know my name.
Helen.
Karen.
Now that's not fair. Dawson had to hold up a cue card for her to remember my name.
Gene.
Well,
that's the original spelling before he was married.
Before he could, yeah. I sure hope you win the money, honey. Yeah, no, good luck to you. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank gang. Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. And if you match the bottom one, you get $100. Three of these ding-a-lings are allowed to help. Which ones would you like an assist from?
Richard.
Our gang.
Our gang. Famous old motion picture group.
Adrian.
Street gang.
Street gang. All right, you've got two.
Bobby.
And Bobby Van.
Chain gang.
Chain gang. So you've got chain gang, street gang, and our gang. Do you want to choose one of those, Karen, or would you like to think up one of your own?
I'll take our gang.
You'll take our gang? Okay. That's the one she hopes is up there under the $500 response. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Street gang. That's the one that Adrienne gave you. All right. That may be a good omen. You might be off to a good start here. Looking for our gang, here is the $250 response. Chain gang. So far, there are two out of three that the celebrities gave you. Now, last chance for our gang. Here is the $500 response. Yeah. Our gang. Our girl, congratulations. Now, you know what that means?
$5,005.
You're going to try for $5,000. That's right. So you're up to $600. Let's see now. 10 times. That's right. You're right. It's $5,000. Now, do you know what you have to do to collect that?
Yeah.
What?
Remember your name.
That's one thing. got to match one of them. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard, get ready to write. Karen will face me. Here is the $5,000 question. This will have to be an exact match. Blank Martin. M-A-R-T-I-N. Now, Karen, he's finished his. Now we need an answer from you, which in your judgment will match his answer. What do you say to that, Blank Martin?
Dean Martin.
You say Dean Martin. Okay. Now, Richard, she says Dean Martin for $5,000. May we see how you filled in that blank?
You forgot, Don. I worked on Laughing.
Rowan. Oh, yeah. Rowan and Martin. You
right next door was Dean.
Who's that on your husband's right?
That's my sister-in-law. My sister-in-law, my brother-in-law, my brother's over there.
Oh, I see. Well, they're all very happy. You know what she just said to me? She says, I'll never forget your name now, but I've, but I've forgotten his name. That's Richard Dawson, and he's autographing the card that won you the $5,000, which gives you a grand total of $5,600. Are you ready to play another game?
Sure.
All right, let's welcome Fred Mills. Here we go. Oh, I'm sorry. There's old Fred Mills. Hello, Fred Mills.
Hello, Gene.
Now, Karen, you want to climb aboard the merry-go-round? And you know Fred. We've spent a little time backstage together. How are you, Fred?
Just fine, Gene. Thank you.
We've got a lot of excitement here on stage, and while she has a chance to get it together, would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, Gene, I'm a commercial salesman. I'm married, no children, native Californian, and I live in La Cañada.
Did he say married or buried?
Married.
You live where? I didn't hear that.
La Cañada. That's a small town above Glendale.
Oh, well, it's nice to have you with us.
Oh, thank you.
Ready?
Ready.
Here we go. Ready? Ready. Good luck to all. Oh. Fred, please make a selection.
Yes, A, please.
A it is, everybody plays, brand new game. Da capo, as we say. After Marvin saw the Mario Lanza movie,
yes,
he sang this song to his girl.
Oh, no.
To his girlfriend.
Please, not too loud.
Well, no. I'm not going to sing it.
I'm just going to give you the
I'm
note.
Just going to recite it because...
Sing it. It's much better.
No, this song
give
gives you a
bell
hernia
tone.
When you sing
yeah.
it. You know, it's a...
Well,
you can't sing that song.
Yes, you can.
No, wrong.
You can't if your shorts are tight.
He sings in the cracks. And, be my love, for no one else can stand my blank. Be my love, for no one else can stand my blank.
Oh, I got,
you got it.
I got it.
Let me just see if you got it. You got it, honey. Right.
Right.
Really, no right or wrong here.
You say that as though there's a right or wrong, and there's not.
No, there isn't. Okay, everybody's all set. Fred Mills. After Marvin saw the Mario Lanza movie, he sang this song to his girlfriend. Be my love, for no one else can stand my blank.
Voice.
What's that?
Voice.
Voice. Voice. Okay. This is voice. Bobby,
voice.
What do you say?
Voice. You know, it just happens. My first movie I ever made was with Mario Lanza.
Really?
Called Because You're Mine.
Yeah.
And God bless him, he's a wonderful guy, but he liked to eat a lot of Italian food with a lot of garlic, and that would have been breath.
Yes. No one else can stand my breath. Okay, breath. Brett, what do you... He
Brett
said breath.
Thomas.
I say I'm having a hot flash, and I have to fan myself for a
minute. Well, let's all fan her. Shall
I
we?
Said breath. I'm sorry.
Breath. That's all right. He said breath. That's not a bad answer, is it? Okay,
not
Gary.
At all. This is my impersonation of a tenor with tight shorts.
Be my love for you alone can end this journey.
It's a subtle gesture.
I said voice.
This show. Yeah, voice. Oh. There's one for you, Fred. How about you, lady?
Well, I hope this is the same thing. I said singing.
Singing and voice. There it is. That's two for you, Fred. Do you make it three?
Hey, why not?
Why not?
As Earl Butt said, why not?
and live to regret it. So that's three for you, Fred. Fanny.
I'm sorry, I said breath.
Breath, okay. So that's three for you. Your first round question will come along in a little bit, but right now this is going to come your way. Here it is. Now we're ready for your first round question. He did well with his. He got three. Let's see how you do with yours. Steve fell asleep and dreamed about turkeys. And when he woke up, he discovered he was blanking his teddy bear. Steve fell asleep.
Yes, I heard.
Oh, my God.
And dreamed about turkeys.
Hmm.
When he woke up, he discovered he was blanking his teddy bear.
Your chair squeaked, Fanny.
I'm sorry.
Blanking his teddy bear.
And it made a funny noise.
Okay.
He went, like that.
Yes.
Did you hear her chair squeak?
Well, we'll have to put a little oil on it.
She needs a little oil all over us.
Speaking of oil.
Not yet, sweetheart, but give me a minute.
We haven't had lunch. All right, everybody's ready, Karen. Steve fell asleep and dreamed about turkeys, and when he woke up, he discovered he was blanking his teddy bear.
Plucking
his teddy bear. All right. That's what she says.
What'd she say?
Plucking his teddy bear.
Plucking his teddy bear.
Right.
I won't even say anything.
Right, don't.
Because I wrote plucking.
You wrote plucking. You know, you call your card upside down every time.
Plucking. Right. Yes. The way you look at it, it's plucking.
Okay.
This way and that way.
Right. So that's one for you, Karen. Brett?
Well, you know I'm a gourmet cook.
Yes, you are.
You all know that.
Right.
So I always go straight to something culinary.
Right.
I said basting.
Basting. Okay.
You don't think that's too
Gary,
terrific?
It's all right. What'd you say, Gary?
Really, Panda, come out and snap his hair off for me.
I moaned because I really strongly wanted to say plucking, and I said something dumb, eating. I'm terribly sorry.
Okay. All right, you should be sorry.
Same to you, Father.
How about what about it, lady?
I don't think it was so dumb. My mind tends to run in the same direction.
You holding yours upside down, too. Eating,
well,
all right.
It works that way, too.
Okay. Now, Richards.
First time I've worked with two Australians. Plucking.
Plucking it is. That's two for you, Karen. He discovered he was plucking his teddy bear, is what she said. What do you say?
Well, plucking. Little teddy bears don't have eyebrows, so I put eating.
Eating. So at this moment, it's 3-2 in favor of Fred Mills. And now we go to round two and ask Fred to make his selection.
A, please.
A it is. Now, three people do not participate. Gary, Adrian, and Richard. The rest do. Joe said, any dog can bring his master his slippers, but my Fido is no ordinary dog. When I get home, he greets me at the door with a blank. Is that mystifying?
Gotcha. While we're waiting, I want to just say that on the 16th of this month...
Yes.
Birmingham, Alabama.
Birmingham, Alabama.
That's 3 days.
Little Fanny Flagg is going to open in Anita Luce's play, Happy Birthday.
Oh, yes. No kidding.
Yes. So all the people who watch this in Birmingham, yeah, go and see her.
That's the 16th. You know, that's not...
Grab her sweater.
That's... Now, wait a minute. To get it right, today... What's the date today?
Today's Friday the 13th.
Today's Friday the 13th.
So Monday. So it's Monday. This coming Monday.
Right.
Well, good luck with that venture.
Quick
one.
My pleasure.
Here we go now with Fred Mills. Joe said any dog can bring his master his slippers, but my Fido is no ordinary dog. When I get home, he greets me at the door with a...
A drink.
With a drink. Okay. What does he greet him at the door with, Bobby?
Well, I said he's drink.
Hey, drink. There's one for you, Fred. And now...
I had the feeling that Fred was Mr. Right. A drink.
A drink. That's five for you all together. Now where do we go?
Right to you.
Right to you, Fanny. Okay.
Right to happy birthday.
The drink, I have to speak to you about your recreation. I said a girl.
A girl?
Yeah.
Well, that's... okay. So that's... you rascal. All right, we had a little side bet going there. Karen Robbins, you've got to have 3 to tie and 4 to win. Santa Claus said... It's terrible that they teach Boy Scouts to tie knots. The last time a scout troop visited here, they tied my blank to the North Pole. That's what Santa Claus said. He said, it's terrible that they teach Boy Scouts to tie knots. The last time really a scout troop visited that. Here, they tied my blank to the North Pole.
He really said that.
He really said that.
No kidding.
Who does not play?
I don't.
Bobby does not play, and Richard does not play. The rest do, and do it expeditiously.
Okay. I'm doing it as expeditiously as I possibly can.
Do you know what
and
that
with,
means?
With dispatch, and quickly. And efficiently. And okay, we got it. Karen Robbins, Santa Claus said it's terrible that they teach Boy Scouts to tie knots. The last time a scout troop visited here, they tied my blank to the North Pole.
Beard.
Hey, that's very good. She came up with a good answer. Beard. Brent, what'd you say?
Oh, golly. I said reindeer.
Reindeer. Got to match the others to stay in the game, Karen. What do you got, Gary?
Take heart. Beard.
Beard. There's one. Another beard. Right.
Slay.
What do you have? Beard missed it by one. Karen Frederick, the game's gone down, Fred. Congratulations. Well, Karen, I'm sorry to say goodbye to you. We wish you well, and we give you the $5,600. And thank you very much, Karen Robbins. We'll be back in a moment, but right now, we've got this message. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75.